Welcome everyone to the Gamers Rant, episode 13. I'm your host, Gamer LCD, of course, and in this episode we'll be discussing the official announcement earlier today made by Sony Entertainment at a press conference, officially announcing the PlayStation 4 and some of their partners. Also, a surprise announcement by Blizzard Entertainment at that same press conference, officially announcing that Diablo 3 will be coming to consoles, specifically the PlayStation 3 and the PlayStation 4. If you guys want more information about this, go ahead and stick with me and we'll be right back. Hello everyone, my name is Gamer LCD, and if you guys aren't aware, this is the Gamers Rant series in which I discuss all of the hot topics in the gaming universe. There is no set date on when I release these videos, they just happen to pop up whenever I feel like talking about something that's a very hot topic in the game universe. So just keep that in mind, and today's announcement is no different. We're going to be talking about the PlayStation 4 officially being unveiled by Sony Entertainment earlier today, as well as the surprise announcement by Blizzard Entertainment saying that they're going to be releasing Diablo 3 for consoles, specifically the PlayStation 3 and the PlayStation 4. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started here. Earlier today, February 20th, 2013, Sony held a press conference in New York in which they officially unveiled the PlayStation 4. Although they did not actually give any physical indication of what the PlayStation 4 is going to look like, they didn't show it off whatsoever, they did give us a lot of details about the hardware about the PlayStation 4, the social capabilities of the PlayStation 4, as well as some of the games that they're going to be developed for the PlayStation 4 and its graphical capabilities. So first up in the press conference, they discussed the hardware of the PlayStation 4. Specifically, they didn't give any specific details such as, you know, the processor speeds or the RAM or anything like that. They did give us the baseline ideas about what the hardware is going to look like. They told us that's going to be based on an x86 chipset, which is something that isn't very surprising. It's going to feature GDDR5 8GB of RAM, which is something you would only see in high-end graphics cards and PCs, such as the 600 series from NVIDIA. You would only see DDR5 RAM in those graphics cards because graphics cards required a lot of RAM in order to run things smoothly. So it's kind of rare that you would see them transition from DDR3 to DDR5 basic memory in a console such as this. They also told us that they will not be having an SSD in their PlayStation 4. It's going to be a hard disk drive, which is very surprising considering that everything is moving towards solid state drives nowadays. But I believe with the way how high capacity things are becoming nowadays, such as movies and video games, things are very, very high capacity. A single game such as Batman Arkham City will run you about almost 20 gigabytes of storage. So being able to install games and game saves and stuff like that on a hard drive, I would understand them going with a hard disk drive because they are a lot cheaper to manufacture and they can hold a lot more memory for less money. A 500 gigabyte solid state drive will cost you over $1,000 almost, or close to it. So I can understand them going with a hard disk drive instead of a solid state drive. Maybe in the future they'll come out with another PlayStation 4, like a premium version or something that'll give you a solid state drive for more money. But for now, they just said they're going to have a hard disk drive. And the GPU is going to be a modified enhanced GPU. They didn't give any specifications of what type of GPU it's going to be. Although when it officially releases, they're probably can find that information pretty much anywhere, especially on Wikipedia. Wikipedia has all the information about the various console specifications. So that was the beginning of the press conference. They gave us a little bit about the hardware, again, not too much into detail, such as processor speeds and stuff like that, but they did give us this baseline stuff. Next in the press conference, they talked about the social aspects of the PlayStation 4. They really wanted to address this, and they discussed heavily about how you're going to be able to take your gameplay directly off the console, and with a push of a button, just directly upload it to YouTube and Facebook and stuff like that, specifically Ustream. You're going to be able to live stream directly from your console to Ustream. They partner with Ustream. I don't know why they didn't go with Twitch TV. Maybe Twitch is going to the Xbox 720. Who knows? But they're using Ustream as their major live stream platform. Also, they wanted to physically address the actual physical button of a share button on their new DualShock 4 controller. Again, I'll be having pictures and stuff in this video so you guys can take a look at what that looks like. So the DualShock 4 controller is going to feature a light sensor pad, which basically is an indicator to differentiate different controllers. So if player one has a blue light sensor, player two has a red light sensor, and so on and so forth. Also, the physical indication of a share button directly to, in the middle of the controller, nor near the left-hand joystick, I would say. You'll be able to push that button and instantly take any gameplay that you've been playing with, such as Call of Duty 8 or whatever, and just instantly upload that to YouTube or Facebook or whatever without even having to edit it or do anything like that. It's still no indication about how that's going to work as far as if you want to edit your videos before you upload them or anything like that. All they indicated was that there's going to be a share button on the PlayStation 4 and DualShock 4 controller, and you'll be able to upload them basically to their provided location, such as Facebook or YouTube as an example. So that was pretty much it as far as the social interaction goes. They want to make it kind of like Facebook, where it's very personal, where your friends list is going to be compiled of premium profile pictures, real names and stuff like that. So they're trying to make it comparable with Xbox 360 so that their online service is getting a lot better in that regard. So you can expect a lot of that with the PlayStation 4, although they did mention that you'll still be able to have your aliases and just various icons that you want to choose, just in case you don't want to share that with random people across the internet. You will still have the option. You don't have to choose it to opt into the personal aspect of it. They also wanted to touch upon the fact that you'll be able to spectate and actually via live internet be able to control someone else's controller via the internet. So if your friend up in Japan is having trouble with this various aspect of the game, you can actually physically take control of his controller via your controller and play the game for him, just to get him past a certain part, just in case he can't do it or something like that. They mentioned that very clearly, so it's something I feel like I should talk about in this video, is that the fact that you're going to be able to seamlessly take control over someone else's controller via the internet and stuff like that. They also talked about the PS Vita and how they're going to integrate that into the PlayStation 4. They're really pushing the PS Vita to get more game console or platform sales out there. They discuss how you're going to do like the Wii U does and pretty much be able to control your PlayStation 4 from your PS Vita. So you'll be able to take your Killzone. They announced a new Killzone game for the PlayStation 4. So you'll be able to play Killzone without even having to be on your console. You can just play it on your PS Vita while someone's watching TV that your PlayStation 4 is hooked up to. So while I'm not a big Sony fan, I find that this is just kind of a huge ripoff of the Wii U. It's not anything new that we've seen so far. Although it's a good idea, I do think that they could have handled it in a better way. I'm not going to be putting my personal opinions in this as much as I can, but I'm just giving you guys all the facts of the information. So they talked about how the PS Vita is going to work with the PlayStation 4, how you're seamlessly just going to be able to live stream everything to your PS Vita, the same graphics, no watered down graphics or anything like that, but you'll be able to do that very flawlessly via their new technology that is going to be able to allow you to do that, obviously. So those are the first things that they mentioned. They announced the hardware of the PlayStation 4. They gave us the new DualShock 4 controller, and they talked about how the PS4 is going to allow you to enhance social networks, allow you to enhance the way you play with your PS Vita and stuff like that. Then they moved on to actual games that they're being developed for the PlayStation 4, where they allowed various developers to come on stage and showcase one of their games that they're currently working on. The first thing they showed us was a new Killzone game. I can't remember the exact title, but it was Killzone Shadow Frame or something like that. Again, could be way off, but I know it had the word shadow in it somewhere. They showed us a new Killzone game. They showed us a new game. Actually, the very first game that they showed us was a game that was kind of cartoony, but it still looked very, very good. I don't remember the name of it. I'll probably put annotations or link or things after I go in and edit this video, so you guys can check that out yourselves. But they showed us a few games. They showed us this game called Watch Dogs. I thought it looked pretty cool. It was kind of a crossover between Grand Theft Auto and Batman Arkham City, to be honest. The graphics looked amazing. They looked like a high-end graphics that you would see like in a CG movie almost. It was called Watch Dogs, and like I said, it was like a crossover between those two games and allow you to it was kind of like a vigilante thing where you're running away from cops, taking down bad people. The physical gameplay that they showed us was this guy. He was running around and he saw this guy trying to harass his lady. So he kicked it. He chased him down the street, did a whole bunch of fancy moves and jumped over buildings and stuff. And took him down, and that was pretty much it. He stopped the cops, and they physically showed us how they're going to be able to interact with the world, answer phone messages, talk to people on the street, take control of buses and trains and stuff like that. So I thought that was pretty cool. It is a PlayStation 4 exclusive, I think. I could be wrong on that, but enough about that. Moving on. Later down in the press conference, they, like I said, they really didn't show us too much on the side of actual specifications of the system. They showed us no physical hardware of the PlayStation 4 whatsoever. They didn't even show what it would look like or any concept sketches or anything like that. They showed nothing whatsoever about the physical aspect of the PlayStation 4, which is something a lot of people were kind of disappointed about. They really wanted to see what it was going to look like. And I think that's something that they probably still haven't finalized yet, or it's too early to show what it's going to look like. So I'm pretty sure it's going to be something we're going to see at E3. Again, this was just an early press conference to basically announce the PlayStation 4 before Microsoft could announce their platform, which is officially scheduled to be announced at E3 later this year in June. So that's when Microsoft is going to be showing off all their stuff. Again, I want to touch up the fact that they did actually announce a release date for the PlayStation 4. It will be coming in 2013. A lot of speculation was saying that it was going to be coming in 2014. But it is official. They didn't give it like a specific release date of like November 8th or something like that, but they said holiday 2013, which means it will be coming this year. There's no pricing information and no bundle information or anything like that. They just, again, this was just an early press conference to give us just an inside look about the PlayStation 4. One other thing I wanted to mention about the PlayStation 4 is that spectator mode. They're really working hard, like they're pushing the social aspect with the PlayStation 4. You'll be able to do things on your tablet, your phone, your whatever, your TV, your Xbox, or I don't even know. But they're really pushing the social aspect of the PlayStation 4, where you're going to be able to download apps for specific games, such as the Watch Dogs. They're going to have a specific app for the Watch Dogs that you'll be able to download and seamlessly integrate your tablet with your video game or your PS Vita and stuff like that. They also pushed a new service where you're going to be able to instantly play video games before you even download them. So all you have to say, ooh, I see this game in the marketplace store, I want to play this game or try it out the demo, I don't have to purchase it, I don't even have to download it. All I have to do is click play, and it will instantly allow me to play the full game or the full trial version of the game before I even download it. It's going to be seamlessly be downloading in the background, no lag, nothing whatsoever. It's going to be seamless, flawless gameplay that they're going to be allowing us to do. So I thought that was pretty cool. I hope Microsoft follows the same suit. I myself am a big Xbox fanboy, Microsoft fanboy. I'm not sounding biased, I hope, but I'm actually looking forward to the PS4. I actually have a PS3, but I hardly ever use it. I was only using it to watch Blu-ray movies, honestly, until I got my Blu-ray player for my PC. So hopefully Microsoft follows the same suit, not to copy them per se, but to, you know, add variation. There is rumor that the Xbox 720 will feature Blu-ray support, so I'm really looking forward to that. They did mention specifically that there's not going to be backwards compatibility with the PlayStation 4 to play PlayStation 3 games, but they said in the long-term run, they are going to allow players to repurchase the games that they have on PlayStation 3, PlayStation 2, and PlayStation 1, pretty much like an online service like the original Wii did, where games over time will be coming towards the Wii that you can repurchase and re-download, such as old games, Final Fantasy X, for example. You'll be able to download that, a PS2 game, on the PS4 and just play it as a digital download. Later down at the press conference, towards the end of the press conference, they allowed various developers and publishers to come on stage and announce various things that they were working on for the PlayStation 4. They already did all the game stuff, so this was just pretty much like game engines, tech demos, and stuff like that. Nothing real too important. They just wanted to show the graphical power of the PlayStation 4 and what the games are actually going to look like. And I won't sound like a skeptic here, because I was actually kind of impressed with how these games were going to look on the PlayStation 4. I was watching via live stream over the internet, so the quality wasn't as good as it was going to look when you're actually playing it on screen on your console, but the graphics looked absolutely stunning on some of these games that they were playing, such as Watch Dogs I discussed a little bit ago. So I'm very excited about the graphical power of these next-gen consoles, specifically the PlayStation 4 and the Xbox 720, or whatever they decide to call it. Again, the next-generation Xbox isn't scheduled to be announced or revealed until E3 in June, so while I have to wait a few more months for that, I'm very, very excited about what I've seen from the PlayStation 4 so far. And I'm actually thinking about picking up a PlayStation 4 myself when it debuts later this year, simply because of, you know, the different direction that Sony's taking with their console. To be completely honest, I've never actually liked the PlayStation 3's online network. I think it was a terrible disaster. I've never actually gotten into it. The Xbox Live features a lot more online features, and it's just an overall better experience than the PlayStation Network. So hopefully that they'll work that out in the PlayStation 4, and I'll actually want to pick one up. Not to mention the PlayStation 4 network is still free, hopefully. We still have no details on that or anything like that. But moving on, I did mention that they allowed publishers to come on screen and developers and discuss various things that they have planned for the PlayStation 4. Two big ones were, of course, Chris Metzen. He came on stage for Blizzard Entertainment and discussed that Diablo 3 would be coming to PlayStation 3 and the PlayStation 4, as well as the some of the lead developers on at Bungie, who discussed the new upcoming Destiny game that they've been working on in a 10-year publishing deal with Activision. So Destiny will be coming to the PlayStation 3, the Xbox 360, and the PlayStation 4. So I'm really looking forward to how that's going to work out. I'm kind of bummed that Destiny isn't coming to the PC, because what we've seen so far from this game when it was back revealed last Sunday at Bungie in Seattle was that this game is going to be a first-person shooter, and it actually looks kind of amazing, set in a new universe that's always going to be online gameplay. I think it's going to be a fantastic game. I'm kind of saddened to see that it's not going to be on the PC, because I am a PC gamer, but I might have to get back into console gaming, guys. This stuff has me very, very intrigued and very, very excited, so I'm definitely going to have to pick up a PlayStation 4. We don't know if Destiny is going to be on the PlayStation or the Xbox 720 yet, but hopefully it is, because if it's not, that's going to be giving me even more reason to pick up a PlayStation 4. I'm actually going to have to pick up two PlayStation 4s because my dad wants one. He's the one that primarily plays the PlayStation 3, and I'm an Xbox guy, so I haven't really touched my Xbox that much in a long time anyways, but enough about that. Moving on, I specifically wanted to, aside from Destiny, I specifically wanted to talk about Diablo 3 coming to the consoles. Now, this is something that intrigued my interest, and I felt like it needed to be a part of this video, because instead of its own separate video, because it is about the PlayStation 4, but it's also about a game that I'm very, very intrigued in talking about, and something that I actually do play on my PC. A long time ago, before Diablo 3 was even released, there was speculation that over the course of the development of the Diablo 3, they felt like the players felt like they were watering down the game to make it so they could play it on consoles, which means that they were kind of like dumbing down the mechanics, making the UI look like it was something that was made for a console so that a joystick could easily move in back and forth between skills and abilities. And it's kind of true. Over the course of the development, they decided that they didn't want things to be over here, and they didn't want things to be over here, so they decided to make everything in the center of the screen, specifically talking about the rune system and skill system, where the way that we pick and pick runes and pick skills, it looks like something that would be developed for a console. And so this had people thinking, ooh, is Diablo 3 going to come to consoles? And obviously, after today's announcement, they will be. So there's no announcement that it's going to be coming for the Xbox or anything like that, but they did say it's going to be coming for the PS3 and the PlayStation 4. Since the PlayStation 4 is coming this year, I'm actually looking excited for this. They said that Chris Metzen said that they were going to have more information about playability. They're actually going to be able to play Diablo 3 on a PlayStation 3 at PAX East. That's their next time they're going to be doing any type of release information about that stuff. So if you guys are interested in that, I don't know when PAX East is, but I know that's a big game developers conference and stuff like that. So go ahead and check that out if you're more interested about Diablo 3 for consoles. Now, the thing that interests me is that I think Diablo 3 is a good game, though the 12 million people who bought a copy of the game would say otherwise. It has its flaws, and the game is still, in my opinion, in development, even though it has been officially released for almost a year now. I think Diablo 3 is a great game. It has a lot of great potential, and the fact that it's coming to consoles means it's going to widen the audience, and hopefully by that time, by the end of the year, when they do release it for consoles, that it's going to be even better, because rumors have it that the Diablo 3 expansion is supposed to be announced at the BlizzCon 2013 in November this year, which was announced a couple of days ago. That will be November 8th and November 9th for BlizzCon, so the thing that has me about Diablo 3 coming to the PlayStation 3 and PlayStation 4 is that They never told us anything about why they were pretty much dumbing down the game. And that's essentially what they were doing. They were making things console viable and console accessible, so that when the time does come when they want to make it for consoles, then the game is easier to play on consoles. But the thing that gets me is that they've known all along that they were thinking about putting Diablo 3 on a console. And they've talked about this way before Diablo 3 even launched back in 2012 of May. Is that they were playing with the idea of bringing Diablo 3 to consoles, because if you guys aren't aware, Diablo 1 was actually on the PlayStation 1, which is something that a lot of people don't know. So if you look on eBay or Amazon or Craigslist or something like that, you might find an ad for Diablo 1 for the PlayStation 1. Good luck trying to buy it, because those things are super expensive and super rare and nobody has them. So if you're looking for, if you're just learning now that Diablo 1 was on PS1, good luck trying to buy it, because it is kind of expensive. I wouldn't say thousands, but definitely hundreds. So the thing that pokes my nose is that, why didn't they just make two different versions of the game? I mean, obviously they didn't have to tell us that they were going to make two versions of the game just to, you know, not surprise people that they were in fact developing this game for a console. But the fact that they were making it the same game developed for a console and PC, they're two totally completely different universes. I don't understand why, if they now know that Diablo 3 will be on the console, why can't they just separate them and make them two completely different games? So fix PC so that it's no longer console viable, but then take this console version and put it on consoles where it needs to be. Because the way Diablo 3 works now, there are a lot of stuff in there that makes it look like it is for consoles, and that's exactly what they were driving for. Unfortunately, they never told us. They said they were toying with the idea for consoles, but they never actually physically said, "Ooh, we're making Diablo 3 console accessible so that you PC lovers out there are just going to be, you know, bashed into the ground and stuff like that." They never actually told us that. All they said was that we were thinking about making Diablo 3 for console. So hopefully, I don't see them changing the way Diablo 3 works until the expansion, but hopefully they'll understand that our PC lovers out there are now kind of pissed off that they were in fact developing Diablo 3 for a console, and that our PC loving days are pretty much bashed, because the way the PC version works is that it's kind of dumbed down and doesn't actually give PC users what they were expecting to have. So enough about that. As far as details goes about the Diablo 3 coming to PS3 and PS4, it will be coming out this year, 2013, along with the PlayStation 4 and the PlayStation 3. There is no official release date, but I did say they're going to be announcing more information about playability and stuff like that at PAX East. You will be able to physically play it if you're one of those people who are going to be going to PAX East. They mentioned that it will be full screen. You won't have to worry about the split screen stuff on TVs. It's kind of going to be like Gauntlet Legends, where everyone's playing on the same screen. You kind of have to move your characters in sync. I kind of find that as a pro and not a con, simply because I liked it, my group, to stay together. And, you know, having people over in this zone and somebody over in this zone is just not a good gameplay experience. So I don't know how that's going to work. I don't know how the control scheme is going to work, and whether you're going to be able to move your, like, a physical mouse pointer, like loot inventory systems and stuff is going to work. They needed no information about that whatsoever. All they said at this press conference that was Diablo 3 was coming to the PlayStation 3 and the PlayStation 4, and Chris Metzen in his wonderful voice told us that, and that was pretty much it. So that's going to wrap up this video, guys. Hope you enjoyed this little Gamers Rant video. I haven't done one of these in quite a while, actually. I haven't done one since the Elder Scrolls Online introduction that I did in episode 12, so I don't know if I'm going to be popping these out more regularly, because I do think that they should be saved for special occasions when I just need to rant about awesome stuff that's happening in the gaming universe. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you want more information about the PlayStation 4 or Diablo 3 coming to consoles, I will be putting links in the description for you guys to check those out. Also, as I mentioned, I did include videos and pictures and stuff in this Gamers Rant episode 13, so hope you guys enjoy those as well. That's gonna wrap it up, guys. My name's Gamer LCD. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want more content like this, go and hit that like button on this video, leave a comment below, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I really do appreciate all my subscribers. You guys have no idea how it feels to know that over 2,500 people are watching your videos, and, you know, that you actually have people that like your video content. It really is a big deal, and I really do enjoy when people like my videos and enjoy the content that I put out. Also, if you do like this video, please hit that like button, because you always see videos out there where people have likes and they always have dislikes. Hitting that like button really is a huge deal. YouTube values the like button immensely, and it helps them put people's videos on the front page and helps people get their videos advertised on that side panel where it glows. So please hit the like video if you do like this video. If you don't like it, hit the dislike button. It's okay, I understand, but not everyone can be happy. My name is Gamer LCD, and I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.